In the last couple of videos, we set up a scenario where company A intends to acquire company B, and they're going to do it by issuing 2 million shares and then giving those 2 million shares to the shareholders of company B, and company B shareholders will give essentially all of their ownership away. So there will be an exchange, 2 million of company A shares for 1 million of company B shares. Or on a per share basis, the owners of company B will give up one of their shares, and in exchange, they will get 2 shares of company A. They will get 2 shares in company A. And we saw that if everyone thought that this transaction was going to happen, theoretically, whatever A is trading at, B should trade at twice that, because people know that they'll always be able to trade in, or when the transaction happens, they'll be able to trade in a B for 2 of these A shares. Now, what happens in a situation, or why would a situation happen, where B doesn't trade at twice of A? So this is the theoretical trading twice as A. So this is 2 times A. What happens if it doesn't trade there? What happens if B's shares are trading, let me just in a color I haven't used for, what if it's trading a little bit lower there? Well, that might be the case because some people don't think that the transaction is going to happen. So they're not willing to pay. They're not willing to pay that full premium for B. But let's say that this were to happen, and you are working at some type of a hedge fund that has some type of model. Maybe it's a mathematical model. Maybe you have some type of shady information where you know for a fact, you are 100% certain that this transaction is going to close, and it's definitely going to close. It's definitely going to close for with these terms, 2 million shares of A in exchange for 1 million shares of B. Now, your temptation might be, well, why don't I just buy these shares of B because they will go up? But what if the whole market goes down? What if the stock of A goes down like this? Then 2 times A will also go down. So you don't want to just buy the stock of B thinking it's going to go up, because if the transaction is really going to happen, B is just going to track 2 times the price of A. So the best way to do it is to really set up a bit of a pair trade here. And so what you would do is, if you think the transaction's definitely happening, you could buy one share. Let me write this down. You could buy one share of B. So you've gone long one share of B, and then you can short two shares of A. And the reason why this will work, and this will only work if you know the transaction is going to happen, is because right now, 2 shares of A are going to be, at any point, since B is trading a little bit of a discount to that, the 2 shares of A are going to be worth more than the 1 share of B. So when you short 2 shares of A, maybe we're at this point right here. Well, let's say we're at this point right on that day that everything was announced. So when you short 2 shares of A, you're going to get $60. Just as a review, shorting is you borrow the stock, you sell it, and you're going to have to buy it back at some future date. So you owe someone 2 shares of A. And when you buy 1 share of B, it's not going to be trading at $60. It's going to be trading at some discount. So let's say that costs $55. So it's trading a little bit of discount to 2 times A. So clearly, just here, you have netted, so 60 minus 55, you have netted $5. $5 net. And then, assuming the transaction happens, at some future date, when the transaction closes, that 1 share of B that you had, you can exchange it for 2 shares of A. So you get 2 times A. And then you could use that to cover your short position. So you use that to cover your short position, and you're left standing with $5 that you essentially made. Well, there is the risk that the transaction didn't close, but assuming the transaction happened, this was kind of a free $5 for your taking.